Now I want to work on the authentication system, starting with the login process. We, at this point, in order to get to our admin panel, we have to go to admin and then login. And that'll take us directly to our admin login page if we're not logged in already, which is fine. But I would rather, instead of doing that, maybe have a button on that login page to take us to this page. This link here is actually coming from Voyager. So if we take a look at the routes that we have in here, we can just do PHP artisan route list. And let me close this up a little bit. You see that we have a bunch of routes that came with Voyager. So if we scroll up a little bit and head to... You see admin login. So we have the get admin login route. That route, the name of that route is Voyager login. So what we can actually do is go to our resources, JS, pages, auth, login page, because remember, our front end is basically built with Inertia. So we have to go to that page and add that. I'm going to close this up a little bit. And then right under the form, we're going to add a div with the classes of text, right, font semi-bold, margin top 4, and on the hover, we're going to have text blue 800. And then we're going to open this up, and we're going to have an href. Okay, we're going to add a colon, and we're going to say equals route Voyager login. And then in here, we're just going to say login as admin. Now we can go back to the browser, and we can head back to that login page. Okay, and as you can see, now we have login as admin, which also has a bit of a hover state. And now if we click it, it'll take us back to that admin login. Now, an alternative method that you can use as well, which I prefer to use because I don't really like people seeing right on the front end of the app that we even have an admin page, is if we go back to this login page, is we setting up a system so that based on your role, so if you're an admin, once you log into that login page, instead of going to the admin login from here, you can log in from here. And once you do, then it'll take you directly to the admin login page. So these are just two different options that I'm giving you. In order to set that up, you would have to go back to the text editor, and we can close this for now. And we need to go to app providers, Fortify service provider. If we take a look at the documentation and we go down to the packages and the Fortify tab, it'll bring us to this page here. And what Laravel has done is they've made it more obvious, basically, how to customize the redirects. So if you come down to authentication and custom redirects, customizing redirects, you can head down to this little section here. In a nutshell, is basically saying that if you want to override the responses that come with Fortify, then you can do them right in the Fortify service provider. Okay, and they give us an example here by using the logout response. So all this is really saying is that if it's the instance of the app, if anything in your app is calling the logout response, then the response, it'll pass in the request, and then it'll return, redirect back to the main Laravel page, which is right here. So we are going to use this in our own way to also handle the login response. So let's head back to the text editor. So how we're going to handle this is, in the register method, instead of calling in an entire function, because you may want to add other things to it, we are just going to call a function that we'll define down below. Okay, so this one will be this register response findings, and that'll be the name of the, copy this, we don't have to type it again, let's copy. And under the boot method, okay, we're going to define a new protected function. So protected function, go ahead and paste that in, open that up, and we'll say this app instance, and then the instance that we're calling is the login response, and it'll be Laravel HTTP responses class, and we're going to call a new class implements login response, and then we need to open that up. And then in here, we're going to have another public function. Public function. And this is going to be to response request. Again, this is coming directly from the Laravel documentation. Okay. So now let's go up top and make sure we've imported the right thing. And this is actually not the response that we need. We need, it'll be Laravel Fortify contracts login response. Great. Now, what I want to do here is first define the role. The role equals auth user role ID. So what we're looking for is the role ID in order to determine whether or not this user is a standard user, or as in Voyager terms, a normal user, or if they're an admin that we've defined, so a super admin, admin moderator, or what have you. If you take a look at the database that we have here, you can see these are the role IDs, okay, and these are the role names. Okay, so we know that our user ID is 2. Okay, this is the role ID for the user, for the normal user. Okay, the next thing we want to do is create another variable, and we're going to call it URL equals route, and this is going to be Voyager dashboard, because remember, at this point, we're logging in, and if we were on the admin login page, it would take us straight to the dashboard. So we are just doing, and we're doing the same thing, but in a different way. Okay, so the route that we need to call is Voyager dashboard. Now what we want to do is switch, and we're going to be looking for role. Okay, and then we're going to give it a case, 5, case, copy, paste. So then the next one will be 4, the next one will be 3, and the next one will be 1, because these are all of the admins that we currently have. These are their ID numbers. Okay, and after this case 1, we're going to return URL, and then we're going to break. However, if the case is 2, we're going to return redirect intended config Fortify home. Then we're going to break. And then, as usual, we'll have a default. And in the default, we'll just say return, redirect, and then break. Now, if you're not sure where this Fortify home is coming from, first of all, it's in our config, and it's in the Fortify config. So if we go down to our config folder, and we go down to Fortify, and we head up to our home key. This is actually from the root service provider. And if we go to that, our root service provider, our home key in the root service provider is heading to dashboard. And that's default. We don't have to change anything in there unless you want to customize it and do something else for your app. That's completely and totally up to you. But that's where all of that stuff is coming from. Okay. So URL, route, Voyager dashboard. So why don't we go ahead and give this a try and see how it works. Go back, go to our login page, and then we type in admin at admin.com, password, enter. Okay, so we're getting a bit of an error. Now, this error is because our login page is coming from Inertia. All of our admin pages are in Blade files. How we sort that out is, if you go to the Inertia documentation and you head down to the redirects, okay, you'll see that it has a command for returning for external redirects, because it is outside of Inertia that we're trying to get to. What we would do is say return Inertia location URL. So let's just grab this. Copy. And now instead of this URL, we'll go ahead and paste that in. And we also need to import Inertia here. Okay, great. So let's give this a try. We'll log out again. We'll open up the inspect tools and log out from there. Cookies. Localhost, clear those out, and refresh. Okay, so let's try it again. admin@admin.com. Password. Okay, great. We have gone straight to the admin dashboard page like intended. Now, why don't we try to test this out? We'll log out and we'll try to test this out with a normal user. Okay, we'll handle the logout in the next episode, but for now, we'll just go back to the login. Well, we have to register a user, so we'll go to register. Okay, so we'll go ahead and use form filler to create the user, register. Okay, and now we're taken to our dashboard directly, like intended. Fantastic. So I'm going to leave it there for now. I am going to make sure to push all of the code that we worked on today up to GitHub, and I'll leave a link for that down in the description. And then I will also leave the link to this redirects page from Inertia so that you guys have easy access to that. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.